so I guess you guys do like it. Here we are.
Who requested it?
The chat.
Okay. You like blue, don't you?
Yep. I am Prince Pompon.
All right. I guess we're back to Kirby's Epic Yarn then.
Woo! It's going to be cheery.
There was still more yarn to get.
Yes, we need all the yarn. I was gonna, just off camera, I'm gonna do more of those little hide and seeks because I'm obsessive and like to do them all and they're not so good for camera stuff, but I didn't do that, so whatever.
Not Yahtzee's girlfriend wants to know what the alternative game was going to be.
Oh, I'll keep it in my pocket. We're gonna do it another week.
I think Not Yahtzee's girlfriend might want to kill and replace you or something.
We've commented on it before. Yahtzee's girlfriend is a long-time viewer. That one's us.
I guess it would have to be.
Woo! Look at that one little waddle dee is asleep. How cute. I don't know what we're doing.
Okay. Okay then.
Yahtzee's girlfriend says never and sweats profusely. That settles that. Yeah. I feel totally saved now.
Sorry, I'm just trying to get a feel for the frame rate on the stream. Because if you're a regular viewer of the streams, you'll be knowing anything I've streamed from the old Elgato has been a bit dodgy on the frame rate.
Well, it looks a little weird. I mean, now I'm watching the Elgato screen, not the regular one.
It's roughly 20 FPS. Well, I guess it'll do. Because this is actually the debut of the new Elgato. I bought a new one. Because I'm that crazy. I ordered 2 days shipping from Amazon. And I've got here since the last streamer.
You should have told me. My mum gets Amazon Prime, so that's free 2-day shipping.
I wanted to surprise you. Hey, thanks for the 100 points, DeathAbbot1992.
Whee!
So where were we?
Whee! We've
done that one.
We haven't done this one. I'm not sure we can, though. I think we need to...
And then we can. There was a thing.
Yeah, well, we have something to do. I just don't know what it is.
Did we do...
Possibly already walked past it and completely missed it.
Is that
it? That looks like it!
That must be it.
No, nope. We found it looking like a little gold.
Ah! I forgot what that button did.
See? We already got all the treasures.
I could have come up with a way better name for an ocean level than that.
Just back us out of it. We've got something else to do, I just don't know what it is.
That's just a noise that things in the ocean make.
Stop! Oh, that one was me. Never mind, I apologize. Alright, I don't know where we're going.
That's like calling something flap flap sky.
Well, there must be something we haven't done yet.
Are you sure it's not that level there?
There it is! I found it!
Oh.
See how it doesn't have a gold star next to it yet?
Yes,
that's
I see.
We haven't gotten a gold star in it yet. Or any of the treasures. Or any beads.
Well, this name is, if anything, even worse than Blub Blub Ocean.
It's actually kind of Pokemon, I think. They're full of...
Deep Dive Deep.
Oh, yeah. Blue Ocean or whatever.
I'm good, Gilesander. Thanks for asking. Yeah, I guess it's ostensibly streaming at 30 FPS, so...
It looks really stoppy and starty in the Elgato screen. Does it look stoppy and starty to you guys?
It's hard to say.
Oops, sorry, I was watching the wrong thing.
It's probably fine. Everyone can see what's going on.
I'm gonna get all the gems.
Everyone's saying it looks fine. Okay.
Okay, that's cool.
Hey, oh, B's in the chat.
I want those! I want them! I want it! Alright.
Yes, Bivanto, I got a new Elgato, can you tell?
Oops. Sorry, I'm gonna throw you out of this guy. It's gonna be fine. Don't worry about it.
Okay, I guess it's just the display on the XSplit windows. Giving me the wrong impression, but apparently it looks fine. I will stop worrying about it.
So also stop hanging out in that spot, it's not a very safe spot.
So, how's everyone been?
Are you throwing one of these guys?
Hey, he had a thing on his ass.
Yeah.
Do we want the thing?
For ages. We got 2 out of 3, and then I stopped being invested.
Eventar says, well, to be fair, it's a Wii U game, so it's not exactly going to tax the device too hard. Well, fair enough. But you know, Wii U is getting on a bit. Technology might be a bit obsolete. I mean, it is HDMI.
That old?
I thought
everybody still used HDMI.
Yeah, I mean, that was my concession. Despite being an old console, it does use the standard HDMI. ShadowFox89 asks, how's the new book coming along? Still with the agent. It's not been so long that I want to chase him up. I'm just between ideas right now, I guess.
Uh-oh, it's fine.
Ow!
Don't touch the glitter! You already learned this lesson the hard way.
I will not touch it again.
Honey, we can't go down that way. That's how I got trapped. Are you paying any attention to the game?
I did not realize we could not go down that way.
I already went down that way and got...
Hang on, I'll get this. These three coins here, that will make up for everything.
No, it won't! Now stop it! We've officially lost all of our beads. I hope you're happy.
No, we haven't. I got them back.
No, we haven't. Now would you please... I can't see when you won't move because the screen follows you!
Okay.
All right, I'm dropping out of this level and you're starting it over again. Now do it right!
I just had a flash forward to the rest of our lives together.
Acknowledge Silky Flannel.
Hey, so thanks for subscribing, Silky Flannel.
You want to do it by yourself?
No. I mean, I've just went to all this trouble of plugging the Wii U back in. Which I hadn't done.
Which you need to do in order to play this game by yourself, making your comment completely irrelevant.
Yes, but I got both the Wii controllers out.
What you've also learned while you're busy probably not paying attention is that we can't damage those things in any way.
Alright then.
Even when they sparkle, they hurt, so you shouldn't touch them.
Ow!
When they're sparkling. Sorry, it wasn't great.
Ow!
Movement in this game, or this level, surprisingly, like, obviously laggy.
It's a bit of an ass, is what it is.
Yeah, it's just like sometimes the momentum doesn't look like it's going to.
How is the pepper? Pepper's lying currently between us. He's ready to strike if anything should threaten us. Like a big scary lion. I've been teaching him to hold still while I put his face collar on. All I'd had to do was assign it a command. I say nose in, and he very willingly puts his nose in the loop. And then wags his tail because he's being such a good boy. Blue Pigeons ask, is Pepper a dog or a baby? See if you can figure it out. This will not stand, sir.
He officially has all of our beads.
Well, he's welcome to them.
No, no, he's not. We need the beads to get an A. Well, now that we have nothing left to lose, we may as well just keep trying.
Hey, I found a thing.
Can we get him from the back? How are we supposed to get him from the back?
Good question.
Is there really nothing we can do?
Hang on. Try throwing me at his eye. I think the buttons are usually our weak spots and stuff. Okay, maybe not. What about his feeler? Can we throw things at his feeler?
That isn't the side where he attacks from, which sometimes he attacks from. I think it's just a light, though.
Hey, why is he...
Oh, wait, he's stunned. Aha! That one.
Well, why didn't he drop any beads?
I don't know. They're all out now. Well, now we can put our newfound skills to use.
Okay, so we just let him suck and not suck anything up, and then grab his feeler and give him a smack. Okay, I got it.
Well, we got a deep sea fangly fish.
Why would we want that? It would remind us of our failure.
Or beat the sticker that we need to collect to pass the level.
It reminds us of our failure. What the hell's that?
Don't care.
Oh, Jesus.
We're about to find that.
I care now. I care more now.
Oh, there's a button we can push to swim faster. I'm just discovering.
Yeah.
Now would be a good time to swim faster.
Yes, I'm pressing the swim faster button as fast as I can.
This is easier with two of us. I'm glad we're both here.
There, you see?
No time! Ooh, a loose in here.
Aha!
Ha ha! I will throw this little thing at you!
That'll teach you to be fat. Or not to be fat.
Whichever the issue was. One of those was an issue.
Sovereign 46 says, I have a deep fear of large sea creatures. By no means an uncommon fear, I'm sure. Just the thought of all that darkness stretching away to infinity below you, and then something huge and horrible brushes past your leg.
Ah!
It's the fear of the unknown, I think. A very understandable fear.
Ooh.
Well, at least we got as far as bronze. See if it lasts.
Honey, I need you to... careful.
So shall we follow it?
I want to get this thing.
Aha, a thing.
Yeah. Woo!
Yay, we've got a fat pink mast.
We did it. What?
We've got a fat pink mast.
What? That's not a euphemism. Now you're just making up euphemisms.
We got a mast that was fat and pink.
Where are we going?
I don't know what's in that space up there, if anything.
Ah, it's fine.
We're fine. You're fine. Aha!
Ooh, you are right to be curious.
I know my exploration-based games.
I think I got it.
Very good.
You want to jump up and check again? It made the sound, but we're not, yeah, I think I got it.
Ow, bugger!
Yeah, that was bad timing.
Ow, bugger again!
Okay.
I'm trying to get my star back.
I know, but you should have... You knew it came around that corner. That was where it emerged.
It's okay. It's fine. We've still got bronze.
You know there's two levels above bronze, right?
Well, you know, at least we get a prize. Everyone below bronze doesn't get a prize. D's still a passing grade, who cares?
A lot of helicopter fans would disagree with you.
And, well, we need that CD.
I know, and we get it this way, please come over here.
Okay. Okay, now you go back.
No! Oh, no, you're right, we need to go back. Careful!
Oh, so I was distracted looking at the chat.
Stop looking at the chat!
I've got to look at the chat! They got to feel involved.
Well, I'm just saying, you keep dying in ways that I've already previously died. If you could learn from my failures... Not bad.
Yeah, it's that thing again.
Yeah, let's go fast.
Gotta go fast.
That hurt.
I got some of them. Oh, bugger!
Did you not swim back? What is happening right now?
I don't know. It all went all weird on me. Well, you can tell it's been a while, can't you?
You usually play Kirby?
Yeah.
No,
not this awful. We're being pretty awful right now.
Yeah, but the levels get really hard. I don't think we're any more awful than we were before. The levels are harder than they've been.
Well, I guess we better hold out for the 5-star. Oh. Yay! Oh well. Silver's better than bronze. C's a passing grade too. Turns out there's a lot of passing grades.
D may be a passing grade, but it doesn't count for colleges. If you wanted to go to a UC, pretty sure they don't accept any class you got a D in.
Yay, participation awards, says Not Yahtzee's girlfriend. of pot. Is it boss time? I suspect it might be boss time.
No, it's not boss time.
I think it might be boss time. Simbazite says, David Attenborough could narrate the weird mold in my toilet and make it sound interesting.
Mold's pretty interesting stuff.
This mold has lasted in this toilet for 500 years. If you clean the place once in a while, perhaps it wouldn't. In a dance as old as time. Do you want to get a gold?
Yeah.
Nothing's too good for my lady.
I can't get away from the door. No, I don't actually want to do it. I don't want to make the audience wait through it. Would you please stop pushing up? Up opens the menu.
I was trying to press up as in move up away from the thing.
I know. Every single time I do that and it seems like they should just make it another button, because, like, you also want to be able to swim, and up is move as well as being.
Yeah, they should just make.
Make it A. Yeah, why isn't it A?
Make one of the buttons go in the thing. It's Capamari. That's a pretty weak pun.
A at the calamari. And.
You can knit caps.
What?
You can knit caps, as is whom? As in a knitted cap.
Oh, you were saying, alright, I guess.
So it's a combination of a potentially knitted item and a deep sea ocean knife form.
You wanna do it together? Being together in boss fights never seems to help. Levels, yes, but boss fights not so much.
Alright. Well, you've selected, so do you wanna go try it by yourself?
I can't try it by myself. Only the person with controller one can try it by themselves. Watch. Observe.
That seems like bad design. Oh yes, here I am. Can't move, I'm assuming it's cutscene. As I'll ever be, game.
You know, we have that same conversation every single time we play this. Every single time I say, do you want to try it by yourself?
Ow.
And you say...
Okay, I see what to do now. You don't want to do that. I was just showing you what not to do there. Get out of my way, you rascal. I wonder if I can get some coins out of you. Haha! I had a feeling I could.
More of those.
Yeah, and again. You won't be taking Mrs. Capamari to the dance tonight. She'll be saying, what happened to all the housekeeping budget? And you'll go, a little pink twat knocked it out of my face. You will feel insecure and emasculated because you could not provide.
Oh, Yahtzee play Ace Combat just subscribes that we have to acknowledge it. That is a hilarious way of getting the point across.
Ah, bugger. I don't have to play Ace Combat, we just have to acknowledge them.
What is Ace Combat? Why are they so invested? And also, why are you so non-invested?
Bleeding blimey. It's like a flight sim, isn't it?
I don't know. I've never heard of it before.
Aha. Ha ha ha. More of your money. Yes, that was your kids' college fund. Yes, that was Sunday lunch. Yes, that was Christmas presents. Yes, this is the electricity bill. Yes, this is the rent. Ha, you're on the street. You're on the street, you little squiddy bastard. Ain't no fucking fiery friends on the street. hit you. Not that you deserve it. Yeah, I mean, that's presumably that's what we need to do to get to the end of the boss fight. But I'd rather just continue taking all of his money away.
Well, that's pretty funny.
I think I've run out of things for him to own now. I've taken away his family and home. He ain't got no savings, he's a bum. Ha! That was... Oh, no money came out. Well, I guess we won.
Yeah, look at that, you got magic ribbon.
Yeah, we've got his magic ribbon. Ha! We took all his worldly goods.
Silky Flannel says you can take away his iPhone in this copy of Ace Combat.
Well, I smashed that boss fight. Yay and yay. I guess.
Yeah, we got the bonus level. And by we, I mean you.
Yes, me am the best.
I read your comment on Ace Combat, but I can't read that loud during our piece.
Foxeye Valkyrie has clipped out that hilarious clip just there about me taking away the squid monster's money.
We don't need to repeat it. This isn't sports. We don't need instant replays. We'll watch it later. The yarn
weaved its way into the fabric. Yeah, I wonder what the next level's theme will be. Back in Dreamland, it was totally supposed to be called King D, but his dad had a stutter. What is going on here?
It appeared that Yin Yarn's Waddle Dee imposters had captured all of the real Waddle Dees. You can't be mean to my Waddle-Dees.
Only I can be mean to my Waddle-Dees.
That was when Yin Yarn's troops decided to show King DDD who was boss.
Hey, that tickles. Okay, that hurts. Yeah, uncle.
And in no time,
I never understood that.
King DDD wrapped up like a
the practice of saying uncle to say you give up.
Only one more step and Dreamland.
I first saw
mine.
It in The Secret of Monkey Island. I didn't get it there neither. Me.
Yin Yarn's sock began to glow.
Okay.
And sucked King DDD right inside.
And can you twist someone's arm behind their back? Just let go and please stay safe.
Dreamland Good will one. Be mine. Not sure what I'll do with it, but I'll figure something out. Could no one stop Yin Yarn from tearing apart the very fabric of Dreamland?
Garth says his dad was called Fiddle. Fiddle Dee Dee.
Fiddle Dee Dee Dee.
Oh, yeah. Woo! We get to go to Iceland next. There'll be levels with penguins, probably, and ice pop.
Do we want to play secret levels there?
Yeah, let's do the secret levels. They're fun.
Ooh. Secret levels with treasure in. Alex RPC asks, this is like watching some crazy drug hallucination. Wonder what it would be like to watch if you were on LSD. Funnily enough, I know what it would be like to play Dark Souls on LSD.
Yeah, that was a weird choice.
It was my comfort zone. It was how I decided I was going to come down.
I was going to knock it. You'd gotten pretty freaked out, but it seemed like a weird choice when you were freaked out.
I found I played actually surprisingly well. Well... On LSD.
Sure, I mean, LSD entirely messes with your perception. As long as you can tell what's still happening, it shouldn't mess with your reaction time or anything.
Not much to tell, Jarl Zander. I was on LSD, trips started going bad. I spent the rest of the afternoon playing Dark Souls to calm myself down.
You didn't freak out for anything.
Well, at first it was kind of fun. I experienced a moment of joy, then it all started going wrong.
Ah! I got bombed! Let me get back up there. Can I go back and get back up there? It's gonna be good things up there. Look at all the- Oh wait, we're auto-scrolling and I'm only just noticing.
Ladder.
Ah! Alright, wait, when do I should go down? You wanna go up or down?
You go up.
Okay.
I'll go down. My pet Russian- Yes, Kes was there. She was my supplier.
Bad things up there.
Alright, come down here then.
Okay. Right, that already happened. Maybe we should both go up. There's like stuff up there, but it's hard to see.
Jump off me! Ow!
Okay, that was really telegraphed from a long ways away.
Sit.
Did we get it?
We got it! That was a skin of the teeth scenario.
Seriously, why are we being bombed?
Because we're pirates on a pirate ship.
Hold on to a weak one of those levels. I can't even get up on the edge of the boat. Please let me back on screen.
Damn, this is going all kinds of wrong.
Wait. We should be. Oh.
Colonel Bum Clown says.
I want to be going up.
Colonel Bum Clown says, pirates of
there's
the.
There's something we missed because you wouldn't go up, and now we can't go back.
I wanted to acknowledge Colonel Bum Clown's clever pun.
I don't care about Colonel Bum Clown.
Well, now the pun's not as good because I've set it up too much. He said, pirates of the Kirby Ian.
I'm not good enough
in
this game to actually stay up there.
Why not?
I can't even get over the edge of the boat when it's rocking.
Oh shit.
Yeah, see, there's always things up there and we never get them. I don't know what I just got. I just got something.
Oh god.
I can't even get up on the boat. I told you, this game gets really hard if you're a perfectionist and you're trying to 100% everything.
I suppose
it's always easy if you just want to finish the level, if you just want to get to the end. But if you're actually trying to get all of this medals, then it's really hard. It is a game with differentiation in it. Differentiation of instruction.
Harder with another player, I fear.
You think?
Yeah, we'll get into this way and shit.
But we can go multiple ways, and we can throw each other at obstacles.
Where are you?
Up here! I'm on the ladder!
Dumb.
There I am!
Have we found any stickers?
We got one! Wait, hang on, I'm just curious. We don't need that one, right? We don't need that one for somebody's room. So it doesn't matter if we get all the stickers.
Okay.
Not that it really matters either way. I mean, we're not perfecting this. We're not 100% in this game. As much as it kills me, we're not. That was not the question.
Yay! We got a bronze medal participation award! Okay, you do it.
I think I'm very slightly better.
Oh, sorry, Renegade Pizza Guy. Did you donate? I didn't notice. Yay! Silvers! Still good. Hey, thanks for donating, Renegade Pizza Guy. I am noticing you.
I'm not watching the Yellow Submarine. I'm thinking of a song that goes along with that.
Are we in, like, the Boy Scouts? Is that why we've got all these patches with things on them?
Well, Boy Scout patches are given for actual merits and achievements, so I'm gonna
Well, that's a point, I guess. We have literally no merit. Pepper thinks I'm fun to lie next to. Is there a scout badge for that?
No, there's not. Are these supposed to be suspended water bubbles?
Bubbles? Yes, I think so.
Alright. I'm following, I guess.
And there's also down here to see.
Yeah. How do we get in there? How do we get over there?
Hey, thanks for the 500 bits, Darth Skippy. Who says, now as you live in America, what do you find are the least and most surprising things about our country? The least surprising?
We went to IHOP the other day, and that was probably part of one of the least surprising parts about.
That was a pretty unsurprising experience. I was like, I haven't been to an IHOP, might as well do it just once. Might as well get an IHOP just to see what it's like. And now I know what it's like.
And did it surprise you at all?
I got a star down there. Thank you.
Yeah, I saw.
I had a crepe with sweet cream cheese in it.
I want to point out that French toast donut that was awful.
I'll point out that sweet cream cheese is really only an American thing. And I guess cheesecake's kind of sweet cream cheese.
Oh, I can't get it! Ah,
yay!
What about cream cheese frosting? Because I would move somewhere else, but I'd like to get away from cream cheese frosting.
Well,
there's nothing worse than being told, oh hey, we have cupcakes, we've got frosting on them, and then discovering, guess what, the frosting has cheese in it! Because that's what you want in frosting, isn't it?
Same thing, I think, but isn't that basically just like a cheesecake filling?
Well, first of all, I don't like cheesecake, but second of all, no, I think it's different. I mean, it's just regular frosting, but it's got cream cheese in it.
You
don't? Just in case you wanted your frosting to taste sort of savory and definitely weird.
You don't like cheesecake?
Not at all.
I like cheesecake.
No, the only time we eat cheesecake is when somebody makes a big deal about how they're providing cheesecake for us, and then I eat it with peace of life.
Well, it's a bit stodgy, I'll admit. I couldn't eat a huge amount.
No, to me it's the same thing. It's like I'm eating something sweet, but then it's got the sort of...
Ah, hell, I'm drowning.
...savory tang in it that to me tastes like it shouldn't be there, but that's just me. Most people like cheesecake.
I like a bit of... I like a little bit of savory with my sweet. I like salted caramel. Just as I like a bit of sweet my savory, like pineapple
like
on a pizza.
Savory with sweet too. I like pineapple on pizza, which is unpopular, and I like salt in my chocolate, and I like chicken and peaches. But really, I'm gonna
chicken and peach.
Yeah, I'm gonna together, yummy combination, or pork and apple.
Chicken goes with a lot of sweet things, like waffles.
Now that's an interesting concept.
That certainly is. Oh, damn, something. Blah, blah, blah.
Oh, you can dash through those guys? Oh, I've been dodging them this whole time. Because I am actually kind of terrible at these controls.
I suppose the most surprising thing has been the sheer range of climates in such a small, relatively small space that is Northern California. I mean, in Berkeley it was pretty cold and windy. And then, once we got east of the mountains, it started getting bloody warm.
They're not actually mountains, they're little... hills.
But today it was bloody cold this morning when I went out to walk the dog.
Tahoe, those are the mountains.
Yeah, it's bloody cold there as well.
Well, you
know,
sometimes.
But then last week we went.
I can't leave without getting excited.
Last week we like drove like 1 or 2 miles to a nearby city to go rock climbing, and I swear it was a lot hotter there than it had been in the city we started in. Why was this? Well, the weather so much different then?
Because you don't. I think it's the same temperature here, and that Yahtzee doesn't go outside often enough to experience it. But admittedly, I'm never, ever, ever actually home, so I can't really certify that fact.
Definition.
I can't get through it.
Still, Melbourne was like that. Weird with the climates. But like summer weather by in at 2 o'clock and winter weather by evening.
Yeah, that's we're actually having a fairly unusual fall here. Normally fall in California, or at least Northern California, is absolutely like it starts out in the beginning of the day being almost as cold as winter and it ends the day being almost as hot as summer.
Autumn.
Yeah, normally we don't actually have an autumn season, we just switch back and forth between winter and...
Yeah, I've been noticing an autumnal change in the air.
Yeah, and it's actually being gradual, and I'm just telling you that it's here.
Oh, bullshit!
That's fine, we already got gold.
Oh, well. Did we get any stickers there?
I think we got one. Amber wants to know who looks after Pepper throughout the day. You do. You work from home.
I am the doggy daddy. I take him for all his walks and feed him and give him love and tummy rubs. That's why he's choosing to rest his head on my leg rather than kisses at present.
Okay, maybe we should go and acknowledge our bead friends so that they stop nagging us to come over and say hi.
Oh, fine. This is exactly the problem with Grand Theft Auto 4. Oops, sorry. Constantly being nagged by our so-called friends. Come on, hey, let's go bowling!
Would I have apple on pizza, someone asked. I don't know about apple, but there's a place in Lafayette, Pizza Antica, that does this amazing pear pizza. It's so good.
I've had apple on dessert pizza.
Well, the pear pizza is savory, but it doesn't have tomato sauce. It's cheese and pear, and I want to say like arugula or something.
There's a pizza and place.
Olive oil, but there's no tomato on it.
There's a pizza place we like.
And it's a very different cheese experience. It's not mozzarella.
The cheese experience. There's a pizza place we like that does Hawaiian, ham and pineapple, and mandarin segments. I think I mentioned it on stream before.
Yeah, they call it luau or something. Where are we going? Oh yes, we're going to our room. Oh! I just, for the very first time playing this game, noticed that everybody's house has their face on the door.
So it does. How narcissistic.
Alright, we have to go not different. This is where she is. She's trying to visit us.
MojoMan55 would like us to know that Swedish pizza has curry and banana on it. Yay! Let's have a party!
Somebody just called our city San Fran, and you should know that only outsiders do that. And it sounds bizarre to anyone who lives here.
Yeah, they get really narky if you call it San Fran. Also Frisco. They don't like Frisco.
That one's worse. Don't say that. But I wouldn't say people get narky exactly. It's just like what are you doing? That's not the name. It's not like Philly. Everybody calls Philly Philly.
I saw an old Eddie Izzard show that he played at San Francisco where he said, "Not San Fran, apparently not." And then he said, "What's that other one you don't like? Frisco?" And then the entire audience booed. Booed and hissed. And he was quite taken aback. He said, "And I see you're a city of snakes as well."
Alright, I don't know what we're doing here. You know what? We have a million beads. Let's spend some of our beautiful beads on furnishings.
The context I've got for that Frisco thing is that I once read, I think it was a Neil Gaiman comic, covered the subject of Emperor Norton. Do you know the story of Emperor Norton?
No idea. I'm just going to buy everything in the shop.
He was a homeless guy in San Francisco who declared himself the Emperor of the United States, and he became a public sensation. But yes, there was an issue about Emperor Norton where at one point a tourist refers to the city as Frisco and he says, "Not Frisco, San Francisco, for this is the city of St. Francis."
Yep.
Yes, Uncle Tusky, I know, it was a Sandman issue.
I'm just buying everything, I don't even know why.
You never know when you might need a cup-shaped whatever the hell that is. Or a cake-shaped footstool. Ottoman, that's the word I was after.
Yes! Ottoman. Those are for fancier people than us. We have a coffee table. I currently have my feet on it. That's the kind of fancy people we are in this house.
Well, that's not an ottoman. I used to have box ottomans.
I know, I specifically said that ottomans are a bit fancier than us.
Fair enough. My box ottomans weren't the least bit fancy.
This actually contributes, I believe, to your percentage. We'll be a higher percentage done in the game because I've
Yay.
Gone to the store. Press A to death.
Why do the little smoke clouds come out of the guy like he's angry every time you buy something?
Oh, I hadn't noticed. They really.
Cobalt Bork F says, Yards say poof.
No, those are flowers. He's happy.
See, I get the impression he's a bit cross when he does that.
They're flowers. These are definitely flowers. Look how they're multicolored.
Well, I can't say anyone who's, like, emitting flowers is necessarily in a good mood.
Well, this guy is, definitely.
I mean, that's probably quite uncomfortable. Coming out of his nose. That's a pretty mundane couch. Of all the couches available.
The ones at the store that don't have any decoration on them, but then you can put any of your fabrics on them to customize it to look however you want it to look.
I see.
Alright, well, I'm done. We're
almost out of money. Because you just get new stock every time you come in.
Oh yeah, even if you didn't buy everything. It randomizes what the store looks like. So if I left and came back a few times, it would be entirely different items.
Hey, thanks for saying you liked We'll Save the Galaxy for Food, Colonel Bumclown.
Never mind, these are the same. Whatever, alright.
Are we done?
Oh yeah, there's a plaza over here that shows you your completion in the game, but they break it down by category.
I see.
So we are 77% of the way through meeting the cast. We have 67% of the stuff. That's what I just did. Apparently, I just bought 67% of the stuff.
You never have enough stuff.
Only 8% done with fabrics, because I've never gone through and bought the fabrics. Have any. 58% of the metals.
We are not a textile household, it seems.
And 66% of the cutscenes. There you go.
Yay. The quest for stuff, says EdJ18.
Oh yeah.
Quite.
We're a consumer household. Quick! Capitalism. You must go back to work to earn more money to buy more stuff.
Stimulate the economy. Can't catch me.
No, because we're not exactly the
same. Can't catch me. Can't catch me. Can't catch me.
I got caught in the dinosaur. So now Yahtzee's girlfriend wants to know, has your opinion of Kirby changed now after all these dreams when you still let your hypothetical child play it?
No. I would make my hypothetical child play Silent Hill 2.
What was the game the other day that you said you wanted our hypothetical children to play with you and I was like, not any chance? It's like Friday the 13th or something, and I was like, not if they're six! You're not playing Friday the 13th when you're six. You murder people brutally in Friday the 13th.
Well, desensitize them early, just in case they ever join the military.
No! No, that's something I would like to discourage in my children. I'm a pacifist, alright?
What if it was a just war?
Then we still need to find a different way to resolve it.
Stuff! Stuff! Oop. Aha!
Ah, very clever. Alright, I'll just bubble.
Ow, bugger!
Okay, you've
done
that. That's pretty fine. Here, I'll do it from that side. Woo!
Ah, you bastard!
Oops.
Just. You know what? Just jump here and I'll jump on there.
Yep. Okay, we slide on this material. It might not be obvious, but we are sliding.
Are we?
Yeah. Have you not noticed? Oh yeah, we absolutely slide on this
stuff. Oh, look who loves chucking stuff.
You have to go in the door.
Well, I've got the stuff. See if he still likes chucking stuff after he is the stuff.
See? Have you not noticed that? We slide and glide.
Yes, we slide and glide. Oh, look who's back for more. Aha.
Ooh, nice. You found a way to the promised land. Oh. I did not anticipate this turn of events.
I'm suspicious of these snowmen.
I was trying to block onto him, but I missed. And I landed back into him. I caught on you.
Ow. Apparently you can wiggle to get out of the ice block faster.
Okay.
Throw me!
There we go.
I like it when you throw me.
That kind of threw me.
Let's go. Waddle Dee got, where do you want him?
You know,
wherever. Mush.
Mush, the phrase is mush.
That's what I said.
You said mush.
Yeah.
I did it on. He say mush.
That's what I said.
Not mush.
That's what I said,
there's
mush.
You could call like grit, mush, or mush, but you can't say mush. Your dog flatterer.
Why not? It is the word to say.
No, it's not! Mush is what they say, not mush!
Yeah, that's the same thing.
Not when it comes to dog sledding, it isn't.
Pretty sure it is.
No, it's not.
How are you spelling it?
M-U-S-E.
Yeah, mush.
No! Mush!
Mush.
You
can't. I'm saying it. I'm saying M-U-S-H right now. I'm saying mush.
But you're saying the wrong kind of M-U-S-H.
There's no other kind. It's all mush. I could pronounce it wrong. I could say mash.
Mush.
That sounds wrong. That sounds wrong if you're talking to a sled dog. Mush? Mush, would you? There's a good boy.
Okay, what country does the Iditarod happen?
Canada?
Wrong. Happens in Alaska.
Well, that's basically Canada.
It's not. It's United States. Besides which, I'm pretty sure they would pronounce it the way that everybody pronounces it, which is fine.
Well, let's get off this debate. I think we've clearly reached an impasse. I want to see what was up there. Be my platform. Jump, there you go.
When I was in third grade, we'd do this, like, a big unit of the year that we had to follow the Iditarod that year. We had to pick,
the Iditarod being, for the uninitiated.
The big dog sled race that they do every year in Alaska.
I didn't know. I'd never heard the word Iditarod before until it came up in that Trivial Pursuit question.
Really?
Yeah, that was the first I'd ever heard of it.
Big dog sled race from Juno to Nome, I think?
Yes, I remember it ended in Nome because that was the question.
I don't think we can go that way, honey. I'm not even sure what you're trying to land on.
Okay, it's this way. Alex
anyway,
RPC
so
asks.
Most of what I know about the Iditarod I learned in third grade. So, admittedly, I'm trying to remember things from many, many years ago.
Alex RPC asks, how competitive are you guys when it comes to Trivial Pursuit and other board games?
Well, my dad is really, like, he's the trivia expert. He knows everything.
Shit.
Are you serious? I bubbled to get. Are you serious?
I fell.
I bubbled to get to you, and while I was bubbled, you tried to launch yourself into.
I didn't know that was a bottomless pit.
Oh, of course. The pit might not have been bottomless, I guess.
You heard a little sleepy dog grunt just then. That was Pepper.
Alright, we should actually think about what we're seeing up there. It's not really working.
No, we still haven't finished this game, You Do Not See Me. We haven't played it in a while. We were playing Octodad and some other things. And Witch's House.
Also, we weren't able to play for 3 weeks.
Yes.
3? Honey, we didn't go this way yet.
Well, how did we get up there?
Well, I was going to jump off your head, but then you weren't. Remember there was that whole thing over there. I guess we could get up there. Now we can't get back up this way.
Guess
but there was
not.
All that stuff. Well, I guess we can. There was all that stuff up there. And we couldn't get to it. Huh. Weird. But not the end of the world.
Oh well.
Somebody asked how you feel about intentionally frustrating things like Octodad. We might have had a different Octodad experience than they did. I mean, when I played that game, I played it co-op like I did with you, but I played it with my brother who was, well, as at the time, was like, ten? So...
Yes, I figured that out now.
Ah, well, we're doing this now.
Oh well. That feels so used.
You just jump.
I don't think. Yeah, it's too high.
Then find another way up.
Okay, jump from here.
No, we're not doing this
anymore. No, just jump straight up from there. There. Bam. Yeah. Aha. I found a penguin mirror.
Someone asked why I'm so judgmental of your play, so play patient with me. Because Yahtzee's a game. I don't video game for the most part. I have some games that I like, but I have like maybe one extra hour a week in which I actually play them. Yahtzee plays games all day, every day.
Well, I didn't play.
I kind of expect him to carry the weight if we're playing together, because I suck at video games.
Well, I don't play Kirby 24 hours a day. I play shit like Grand Theft Auto.
I have literally never beat the platformer. Nope, that's not true, I beat Fez. Fez, the game that picks you up and puts you on the platform every time you fall off again.
I never know when that game's beaten.
Well, I've completed it.
Not even like Mario 1?
No, never beat a Mario game. I really like Super Mario Galaxy, but never beat it. Wait, one other exception. I beat Braid, because you can rewind that game, so even if you have to try the same jump 3 million times before you actually make it, you can still redo it infinitely until you actually get it.
Fair enough.
Okay. It's
I guess you're not on this, you're not up with this whole retro style of games that have a life system. And say, game over if you run out of lives.
Oh, goodness, no. Certainly never beat a game with a limited number of lives.
Let me out! Yeah, we need to be on top of this thing.
Okay, and I'll just follow. Nice!
Chest. Hey, a huge eyeball. Just what I always wanted.
Nidhogg rings a bell.
Have you played that? It's that two-player competitive sword fighting game.
Oh yeah, we played that for like 5 minutes.
There's a Nidhogg 2 now.
Really?
Yes. Oh, you get this. I don't know what the timing is.
Very surreal to be the person in charge of getting the timing right, because normally that is anybody else's job but mine.
Oh, we only got broads. not Yahtzee's girlfriend, who again has probably got secret plans, says, Kes, don't tell me you're one of those elusive fake gamer girls.
With the trademark. Oh my god, I love it. I don't know. I mean, in a normal room, I would identify as a gamer because I'd be with people who never ever play video games. But in this room, I don't sort of identify as a gamer because I'm with people who are actually gamers, you know?
I'm hardcore, baby.
I'm still very slowly working my way through Saints Row 4 with my brother in co-op, and...
Saints Row 4 is a gamer game. It's not like, Bejeweled.
Yes, but it's taken us like a year.
No, it just means you're savoring it.
Please acknowledge the British potato. I want to get out of this conversation. I'm really testy right now.
Thank you for subscribing the British potato.
You do all.
But yes, if you're taking a while to play a game, it just means you're savoring it like a fine wine.
Right. My point is not the kind of games I'm playing. The point is the volume of games I'm playing. I mean, you know my job right now. I get to work at 6:45 and I start at 7 and I often don't get home until 7 on the other end of the clock. I don't have time for video games.
No one's gonna judge you for not playing video games because you work for a living. That is how normal people operate. I am a freak. I understand this. I'm a 35-year-old hardcore video gamer. 35
minutes. Why I expect you to be good at the time.
I am. Mostly.
You are when you're paying attention. And then the reason I would get frustrated would be because you weren't bothering to watch to see that the big fangy thing with teeth actually was a big dangerous fangy thing with teeth.
It's a well-known statistic. Oh shit, are you serious?
Yeah, those levels on scroll.
It's a well-known statistic that your skill at a game goes down 60% while streaming. I didn't just make that up at all.
You absolutely just made that up.
Well, it's true. You always do a bit worse when you know there's an audience.
I've never taken a class in statistics, which is quite the feat given my undergraduate major. But I know enough about statistics to hear an obviously fake one and recognize.
Alright, it's an estimate. But yes, because I have to pay attention to the chat, and I'm constantly worrying that I'm being observed by people, my skill level tends to go down.
I understand that it does decrease your skill level, I understand that. But the 60% part was bogus. You didn't have an exact number, so you created a number.
Yes, spurious rigor. Sounds true, doesn't it?
Sure.
That's the beauty of spurious rigor. Come on.
Someone asked if I follow any TV. I don't have time to watch TV. But you're watching Aqua Teen Hunger Force right now.
Yeah, I never watched it before. And I like a few other Adult Swim shows, so I've been catching up.
I can't watch whenever I come in and it's on. I saw a few episodes of that when I was like a little kid and my older brother was a teenager and he was discovering Adult Swim and it was sort of the cool thing at the time, I guess. But as a young child being exposed to it at an age at which I wasn't ready for that, it was really horrifying. I have these vague memories of the episode where, you know, the milkshake gets plastic surgery and it's really graphic and
I watched that one the other day.
Horrifying.
Yeah, that's adult cartoons for you, I guess.
Right, and if I'd seen this as an adult, I'd probably have a different opinion, but seeing as a child, I was like, oh my god, I don't know what this is, but I want to.
Oh. Boy, I screwed that up. You don't like Rick and Morty either, do you? Because it's... Well, that's kind of the point of these adult cartoons. They're edgy and weird and horrible. Like Beavis and Butthead back in the 90s. It was...
I've only seen like an episode and a half. But in that episode and a half, I mean... What's his name? Which one's Rick and which one's Morty?
Well, the scientist is Rick.
Excellent. Rick has just such blatant disregard for everyone surrounding him, and he had this child who was sort of relying on him and trusting him, and that was completely being abused, and it was just sad.
I guess there's an expectation with that sort of thing to be a dark mirror to what is generally considered to be a cartoon series. As in, like, wholesome and nice. Although, adult cartoons have been around since The Simpsons, so it's not exactly a new idea to be a edgy cartoon.
I don't know what that means. Somebody said T20 thoughts can. I don't know what any part of that means.
I don't know.
We saw Dark Mirror. I think someone told me I should see it at some point in the episode.
That's a very dark show.
Oh, no, I'm thinking of Dark Crystal, not Dark Mirror.
Black Mirror. That's a Charlie Brooker show. It's basically, the premise is basically, what if phones but evil?
Tetanus Frisbee is vouching. He says Rick and Morty has a real heart, which I have heard about it. As I said, I have not seen enough of the show to form a comprehensive judgment of it.
With the early episodes, they're sort of taking off the whole...
Oh, we should probably go. Somebody says Archer as well, worth
a lot. Bugger. Oh, bugger.
Yeah, that was not worth it at all. I told you should go.
I just want the thing. Yeah, I have the thing. Yeah, Rick and Morty sort of, at first it like plays up Rick being really irresponsible because it's, you know, it's parodying the whole brilliant sci-fi scientist with his boy sidekick thing.
Right.
But as it goes on, as the characters develop, he starts to get more caring. Within a given value of caring.
Right? Somebody also asked about Archer at a certain point, and you have binge watched every episode of Archer within the last month or so.
Yeah, I binge watched Archer.
Yeah, you watched all of it in like a week and a half.
I had a new Hulu account, I was making the most of it.
And so I saw some of it because of that. I don't know, I kind of went back and forth on it. Part of me really liked it, and part of me kept being exasperated because all the characters were pretty awful people.
Well, it's part of the course with Adult Swim, I guess. All the characters are going to be really awful people.
I really liked the scientist. He was my favorite character. Because he at least was sort of... I don't know.
Look, Krieger.
I don't know.
The Nazi scientist.
Yeah.
Alright.
It was an interesting sort of little... His little arcs sort of were interesting. And since he was sort of the Nazi reincarnate scientist, then it was like, he's not supposed to be lovable, he just is what he is, and he was always sort of, I don't know, I really liked him. But I guess for some reason it felt less ambiguous, like he was sort of more unforgivingly who he was. And there were good parts of that and there was bad parts of that, but that just sort of was what it was.
Okay.
Whereas a lot of the other characters were like, I'm trying to do the right thing, and I'm messing up in the most spectacular way, and I want things to go well, and I want these things out of my life, and I am actively fucking it up in every way I humanly could.
So Vladimir Estrade says, so you're technically a Nazi apologist.
good.
You want to drop back in?
Not really. That went very smoothly without me.
Oh, come on.
I am very confused by Pam, because again, I only saw whatever episodes Yahtzee happened to be on when I was home. So half of what I saw Pam was Pam...
Oh god, controls, what's the controls?
Pam being the HR person and being, you know, obsessed with sex or whatever. And then half of what I saw Pam was Pam on cocaine and being a very different sort of a character, I thought.
Yeah, her character went through a few things.
I can flap my wings, but I can't tell how much that really helps, and I think that's the only thing I can do. Oh, we have more wings. How do we activate those wings?
I don't know. Yes. 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 Where's all this shit? Shit! it. There's some shit.
We got one. Hey, we needed this one. We can put this in the apartment.
Be still my heart.
How did we activate these rings? What do they do?
Snowman! Snowman! Oh, we missed the snowman.
Oh,
I missed the snowman.
We are not figuring out these controls. This is not working like it's supposed to.
I guess not.
Can I do anything to press button on the wings? I don't think so.
Okay. Well, could have gone better, could have gone worse. Raymond Kurtesk says, do you want to miss a snowman? Oh, you have to pop off before three, don't you?
Yeah. Oh, and it's after two, so you need to show Ned.
Oh, so I do. Bear with me, viewers.
I'll just go put this... new patch. This secret room.
Hang on a minute.
Alright.
Look at the bloody options. Hmm? Look at the bloody dashboard menu.
I don't know.
Oh, there it is. Okay, I have pressed the run add button. I'm going to receive that word.
I drop out. I can't. Normally the camera follows you, but now it won't. I just need you to help me with this. Would you just.
Where are we going?
We're going back to the apartment to put in the new piece of furniture.
Oh, yes. Well, suddenly I'm the blue man. Draco Ranger asks, Yahtzee, what do you think of Mitchell and Webb? Huh. Interesting timing. I was just watching some old Mitchell and Webb look sketches on YouTube the other day. Yeah, they're fine. I like David Mitchell particularly. Like him on panel shows. Because he's awkward and clever.
I think being awkward is just his bit. He really is.
Is there a button we can press just to go back to the...
Would you please just go?
I'm just asking if there's a shortcut.
I don't know! Why don't you look for one? Why would you ask me this question?
Apparently the minus button will bring you to the world map. Okay then. Thank you, Draco Ranger. In Adazo 70 asks, how come it's just Kirby's pad? Why doesn't the blue guy get a pad?
Blue guy doesn't get a pad because he's a prince and he literally lives in the enormous castle behind us.
Yeah. This whole country is his pad. Don't mess with him. So it was that chimney thing, weren't it? It's Buster! Darth Skippy asks, Yahtzee, will there be dramatized versions of your audiobooks? What, they're not dramatic enough for you. I don't think so. You'd have to hire actors for that, wouldn't you? I don't think I could get away with doing all the voices under those such circumstances. Yes, Jack T175, Stephen Fry left QI. He left ages ago. It's Sandy Toxvig now. Alright, so we need future TV.
Yep.
Which looks like it's in the next world.
Oh,
which is presumably a sci-fi land.
Maybe. Or it could just be part of this world. Only in a couple levels.
Oh, yeah. I'll switch back again.
Sure.
Okay. Aha! So if we press minus, we can just go straight there.
Cool.
That's convenient. Okay, I'll just play then.
You can't get out. I don't know how to leave. Then you just start a level.
Yeah, I'll just start a level. Which one haven't we done?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, it was this snowy thing, wasn't it?
Go back. There we go.
Yeah, there it is. Okay. You acknowledge the chat.
I'm tired.
Well, you have worked this morning.
Yeah. I think it's got more to do with the fact that I've been putting in over 60-hour weeks than the fact that I worked for 2 hours this morning.
Well, it kind of helped. Pepper, stop licking my leg.
Sorry, facing out.
Don't worry about it. It's a little weird that I demand this of you every weekend.
Well, I'll admit, it would be nice to have some free time on the schedule, but...
And I can't berate you like I did Gabe. He complained about being hungry and yawning all the time, I'd just call him a knobhead.
Aw, Fox gave 100 bits.
Hey!
Showing appreciation.
Thanks, Fox 23.
Come on, Pepper, you come up here and cuddle with me and we'll talk to chat.
There. Pepper will make keep you alert.
They sure are cute levels. They've done nice things with the design. I like the pink and the purple and the blue.
Now, there's a chest. There's off a platform. I think we're done here.
So do you recommend any snacks for a curious Californian?
Snacks?
Mm-hmm.
Snacks that can be readily found in California?
Oh,
piss.
Oh,
well.
Oh, somebody else said the solution is to kidnap Gabe, keep him in a cage next to Pepper, and only let him out in the streaming time.
I don't think he'd be on sparkling form under such circumstances.
Well, to be fair, what you guys do best is bicker, isn't it?
Well,
you certainly have a good head of steam by the time you let him out.
Well, I used to rag at him because he wouldn't be pulling his end up, and I wasn't sure why. And under such circumstances, I would know exactly why he wasn't being effervescent and interesting. It will be because I've been torturing him.
Did you ever ask him? Maybe he had a very good reason for not being.
Well, sometimes he gave some shitty story about how he'd been donating blood that morning. Ha!
That actually sounds like a really good cause.
Pull. Well, if you're into blood.
I've never donated blood and always felt guilty about it.
I never donated blood and I was angry about it because they wouldn't let me.
I never did when I was a kid because my mom would always plan these vacations, which were very cool and interesting and fun, but in countries where then you can't donate blood for a year or whatever because you might have some kind of...
Yeah, they wouldn't let me donate blood in Australia because I lived in England during the BSE epidemic. Apparently there was some chance I might have symptomless Creutzfeldt-Jakob disease.
Well, to be fair, it's a really terrible disease.
I'm not sure it's ever symptomless.
I have no idea.
Oh, you think you're very clever. Oh, you thought you were even cleverer.
I am also afraid of needles. And pain. Ooh. Well, even after I could start giving blood, I just... I'm
dead
because it's scary, but I always feel like I need to, and someday I'll actually.
No one has the right to demand your blood.
Yeah, I know. Legally, nobody can make you do anything with your body without your consent, except potentially the whole abortion issue, but that is a whole can of worms.
Yeah, I don't know my blood type either. Fresh till death, 56.
Yeah, me neither.
Bet we'd know if we were Japanese.
I'm not sure that the whole blood typing thing is a common belief anymore. I know it has been historically. Aw, Uncle Tusky has to give himself an injection twice a month and hates needles. That would suck.
You'd think he'd get used to it.
I don't know. Stuff you get desensitized to, but you never quite get over.
I mean, I found it hard to put in contact lenses when I first started doing so.
My mom says, oh, you might be awful with needles all the way up until you're pregnant, and then they'll inject you every 6 seconds and...
Bugger, 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 bugger.
Then you'll get over it. So I've got that to look forward to, I guess.
Yeah, I guess I got over needles when I was getting my teeth done. Because they stuck needles right in my gums.
Max, somebody...
They sprayed the thing on that was supposed to numb the skin first. It bloody didn't.
The last time that I got a dental procedure done where they had to numb the skin, then I discovered hours after the anesthetic had worn off that I was pretty severely allergic to it. It had, like, torn the skin off the inside of my mouth in the same places it has numbed it. It just kind of felt like, you know when you burn your mouth badly from like pizza or something and the skin peels away later?
Oh, I hate that.
Yeah, that happened, but I hadn't eaten anything hot. The only thing I'd done that day was get... In fact, I hadn't eaten at all. The only thing I'd done that day was to have my mouth numbed with this procedure. So I realized like, oh, while it was making it numb, it was also burning it, which was sort of like horrifying to think about. Not a big deal, obviously. It's gonna run off your back, but,
Oh well.
Gross!
I want that star.
Dark 99 says, 6 shots per day of 2 different types of insulin. You get over it. Winky face.
Suppose you would.
That would suck.
How are you with touching your eyeball?
I don't have glasses, so I have also no experience with contact, and therefore no experience with touching my eyeball.
Could you touch your eyeball?
I did once when I was a child, just because I wasn't sure if it was possible or not, so I tried it and it was. So I guess that's good, because if it turned out that broke your eye, I absolutely would have just blundered right into that.
Oh, bullshit! I can touch my eyeball right now. Ooh.
Oh, stop it.
I didn't pick up any pickups then. Oh. Actually, I did. Oh, actually, I got all of them. Never mind!
Pepper. Now the chat's talking about how Japan may or may not have had a fad where young people licked each other's eyeballs. There's a kind of newt, I think, or gecko or something, that doesn't have eyelids but keeps its eyeballs moist by continually licking them.
Yeah, it's fine to lick eyeballs because your tongue's moist, so it doesn't,
you barely feel it, really. Bacteria, which is what someone says.
Well, quite. But at least it's
cases of that.
Quite. Do not let an AIDS patient lick your eyeball.
Would that cause a problem? Because you can't get AIDS through kissing, so I don't know that licking an eyeball would cause any more problem.
Eyeballs have open blood vessels on the surface. If AIDS-infected bodily fluids get splattered on your eyeball, you are at risk of contracting AIDS yourself.
But their saliva wouldn't have AIDS in it unless they happened to have an open sore.
Well, who knows? I know that if AIDS-infected blood gets on your eyeball, then you're in trouble.
Really noticed.
Hello, John Markley. Hey, Pepper looks pretty sleepy and tired.
ShadowFox89 wants to know what digestives are, which is good. Oh, and we want to let all of the YouTube viewers know, like we've totally been saying all stream.
Yes, we have.
That you should be joining us on Twitch, where we have the chat that we're moderating. So if you would like to join the chat, feel free to join us on Twitch.
Yes, come to twitch.tv/escapistmagazine. I guess I'm fighting King D now. Hello, King D.
Wait, is this the one that wasn't? Oh! Alright. This is all cool. His eyes turn a different color. The way you do when you get strings attached to the rest of your other pieces.
I slapped him on the bum.
Someone asked what my favorite class was. I don't know that I had one in school. I was pretty good at math. I was a couple years above my peers in math. In fact, my junior year of high school, I ran out of math classes to take. Therefore, I didn't take one in senior year. But,
aha! That's how you hurt the bastard. You have to pick
but
up the stars that come out.
I think at the time that I was like, oh my god, yes, math. I think at the time I was like, no, hating math is what most people do. I guess I don't have much of an opinion. I kind of liked my chemistry class. I kind of liked my physics class. But that must have been because of teachers.
Yeah. I liked history class best because that was the best teacher. Mr. Bedgood.
And you still remember his name?
Yeah. Because we got so much mileage out of it. Mr. Bedbug, Mr. Deadwood, Mr. Good in Bed. Ha 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 ha. I hit him in the face. Ah, I hope he got brain damage. Am I supposed to be grabbing those things over there?
Yeah. But it's probably the best time to get them. Uncle Tusky sharing that he had a girlfriend in high school who went to college for math because she ran out of high school math classes. I just waited until I got to college. I finished with all of the levels of calculus that high school offered in second by my junior year. So then I just took multivariable my first year in college. Handsome Aaron wants to know if it was a girl who came out with the, came up with the alternative joke, Mr. Good in Bed. I'm going to guess it wasn't.
No.
All boys school.
I went to an all boys school, yes. But there were girls in the sixth form. There was a sort of partnership with the local girls' school to cover all the different courses that could be offered by the curriculum.
I went to an all female college. And we just had a partnership, because we were a pretty small school, we had a partnership with the other very small school next to us, which was co-ed. So you could take classes at either pretty much equally easily. You could major through either equally easily. You could even live at either schools. We did have some boys living on campus. Fun fact, guys, if you're a boy and want to attend an all-girls school, you functionally can.
More shinies. Give me all your blood.
Now, see, guardian has a trust bar where the eye is more reliable the more you care for it and pet it. Thoughts?
Again, reminds me of the GTA 4 mechanic where you have to keep taking your friends out on dates. I mean, I know it has to define.
Would you not stand directly underneath that thing?
Ah, you bugger. Ah, you bugger again. Damn it. Why can't I get them anymore? Oh, there's one. Oh. That's exactly more better because dates in GTA 4 were like looking after, were as fun as looking after a plant.
Somebody, Jack somebody said, I'm heading off to college in a few days. Any advice? Don't lose track of your social life, but don't let that get in the way of your studies either. Figure out what you want to do as early as possible, because college is expensive, so you don't want to spend more time taking classes than absolutely necessary. I feel like when I was in college, everybody told you, like, oh, yeah, you'll figure out what major you love, and then you'll figure out how to turn that into a career. I wouldn't advise that now, having gone through the process. Figure out what career you think you want, and figure out what classes are into that. I know a lot of people that I know who took really unprofitable majors that did not prepare them for good careers. And it sucks when you finish the major you love and it took a lot of work and a lot of money and then it really doesn't work for your career.
No way. Come on. Why is this so fiddly?
MC says the best advice for college is to beat the crap out of someone on your first date because they know you're someone who'll stick up for yourself. I think that's jail. I think you're thinking of jail right now.
I think that was the joke. Oh. This is done to piss me off.
Not yet. His girlfriend wants to know if I read the crossover fanfiction of you and My Little Pony. I'm aware that it exists. I have not read it.
Are you threatened by its existence?
Threatened in what way?
I don't know. Physically?
Do I think that it's gonna come knocking on my door? No. Do I think that you're actually gonna leave me for a pony? Also, no. Cast which pony is Yahtzee? Well, I haven't read the fanfiction, but speaking of what I know about the series...
I know nothing about the series.
Oh, you'd probably be... that dark and broody one. Celestia's sister.
You clearly know a lot more about My Little Pony than I thought.
I actually saw a few episodes... well, several episodes from the first season. They had these cute little songs in them that were very charming.
I got it then. I swear I got it. Oh, finally.
You did it!
There,
look,
I did
it. DDD's eyes are back to their normal color.
Kitten Chili, would someone who sucks at this game win the boss fight with all the prizes? I think not.
Someone else asked if I plan on playing more RPG Maker games. I wasn't planning out mostly due to process of elimination. He's already seen Let's Plays of all the good ones.
Yes.
But I like RPG Maker games, so I'd consider it.
Whoop de fucking
day. I really want to make him play, God, what's that game called? Embrick of Wolfhammer, which is a bizarre and bizarre game. But it's got like anime boobs in it, so I'd have to figure out if those YouTube would be happy.
I would be.
Well, I'll work on it, maybe. I mean, they're a pre-scripted moment, so we could just...
anime boobs, you say?
We could just have one of those pop-ups, like the Pepper pop-up, but a large one that covers the entire screen.
Hey, look, it's that character who's really out of place in the Kirby universe.
Unlimited Laser says we could cover it by putting in anime boots, but I think
perhaps, yeah, we could just overlay a Playboy centerfold over all of the anime boots. And then you could go, it's alright, I'm not getting off to anime boobs like a weirdo.
What? Go there! Yin-Yarn crashed onto the deck and completely ambushed Meta Knight.
Meta Knight is a little bit anime for me. Suck it to
you? Well, maybe I'll see if I can find it again and work on it
and
for next
just
week.
Like that, Meta Knight was gone. Now Yin-Yarn.
Which bit of Yin-Yarn is his eyes?
That's a good question. I always assume they're kind of hidden behind the mustache, but now that I think about it, that would be a weird place for eyes at the same level as your mustache.
For the longest time, I just thought that he had one eye, and the one eye was the button in the middle of his face.
Yeah, you might be right about that. I can see that. Maybe he doesn't have eyes. Oh, wait, I was talking over the cutscene and I missed it. So wait, hang on. We just had the whole thing like teased and built up that we need to say or DDD was evil, but also we need to save him. And then we did it, and they just whip out of nowhere like, never mind, it was Meta Knight that you had to save. Do that one.
Okay.
Am I interpreting this right?
I guess. It's just here's some classic Kirby characters, and they get corrupted, and you have to fix them. Okay then, Frigid Fjords it is.
Simberzite said a few minutes ago that he thinks Meta Knight is a serious character, he or she thinks that Meta Knight is a serious character who got transported into the Kirby universe as a punishment.
What, like Captain N in the Game Master?
I thought
it was just that.
Of course he did. Garf says DDD son is called Dumby Dum. Right.
Oh, it's one of these bloody races.
I could be a little jetpack. I'm the best jetpack.
I think it's a bit late for that.
No, I can't jump. And all the buttons, I'm not doing
it. Well, just leave it to me. I'll get all this stuff.
Hey, look, you got a chest.
I got stuff. They haven't mastered the art of choosing a faster car in the first place.
It's just me, or is that how a lot of racing things work? You just...
Yeah, just
work
hold
until
down...
you earn the fast...
Ah, yep.
You work at the whatever the mechanic is until you earn a faster car, and then you use the faster car to be faster than the other cars. Not all racing things. There's some that actually require you building the skills to be faster than the other cars, but...
Well, as I keep saying, I've been replaying GTA 4, and I think there might be some compatibility issues with the latest systems, because the NPC driving AI has really gone to shit since the game came out. The races are all piss easy, they all just crash into the wall at the first turn, and you just sail through the rest of the checkpoints. Every now and again I'm crossing one of the bridges, and then at like a given point as you're going over the bridge, all the traffic just steers right and smacks into the wall.
Say, Kess, do you happen to have a game of the year in mind yet? Have I played any games that come out this year?
What? I didn't come first!
Apparently.
I'd better try again then.
If you want.
What time?
Right, aim for the red.
Okay.
Normally you actually get what you aim for.
Hey Peppa.
Ooh, have I played any games that came out this year?
Peppa likes it when I make that sound.
You don't have any idea. Alright.
Peppa. Oh, Peppa. Oh, God. I'm being attacked. With licks.
Yahtzee's not answering my question.
Sorry, what was your question again?
I asked if I played any games that came out this year.
Not as far as I know.
Why are we walking away with the patch?
I forgot to use the patch, sorry. I will go back now.
No, too late. The patch is gone forever. No, I'm kidding. Yeah, we've been having some I know I mentioned this on stream before, but I've been having some compatibility issues with Saints Row 4, specifically playing in multiplayer. It's been going wrong.
Yeah, that's getting on a bit now.
Yeah.
Also, we've got a Windows 10 machine.
Right.
Hey, Pepper, make a funny noise. If we had a toy, we could make him growl.
And a ball. But I can't play tug of war with a ball. Pepper, where's your alien? Where's your alien? I see your alien. Are you gonna get it? Are you gonna get it? Pepper, go get it.
Yeah, don't just stare at me.
Pepper, where's the alien? Where's the alien? Are you gonna get it? You gonna get the alien? Are you gonna get the alien? I'm gonna get it. Oh no, Pepper, Mama's gonna get the alien. Oh, fine, I'll actually get the alien. Mama got the alien! Oh, it's too late now. Now fall asleep. No, it's my alien. It's my alien.
Pepper now has the alien.
Pepper takes possession.
Come on, Pepper, make the noise. I live for the noise. There you go. Make the motorboat noise. There you go. He just gets a bit growly when he's playing tug of war. Two,
are
one.
You gonna get it? Where's the alien? Don't know. It's behind you. He's not even trying to look for you. He just wants to come back up.
Two players then?
Yeah. Oh, but this is gonna be my last one. I gotta go pretty soon.
Oh, okay.
I have to get the tires rotated, and there's a lot of complicated reasons why it has to be today, but it has to be today.
Yes. Don't know how long that'll take though.
Well, if you keep playing for a while, I'll do that.
Probably not that long.
Bad.
Maybe I'll play something else when you're gone. We can make it a chill stream. For chill people. Yeah, this elevator's gonna complicate things, isn't it?
Yep. Be careful, that little guy can do bad things.
I see. I can do bad things with my eye too. It's called ogling. Bang, bang, bang. Yeah, we got it. It was just sequins. The action's really hotting up now. Yay, we got a holiday tree! Ugh, the war on Christmas strikes again.
How are we gonna get this political candidate bowed into the war on Christmas?
How many more lives must be lost in the war on Christmas?
Okay, apparently things are very cold.
Ah, get me. Should we get rid of these things? Oh wait, we can't. Ah, the thing. I will get the thing. Rarefoil says, you know, a co-op classic Castlevania game would be fun and chaotic. You need to check out Castlevania HD. Which stood for something. It was like... No, it was like Castlevania Harmony of Despair or something like that. I know it's not Harmony of Dissonance because that was the other game. But yes, there was a game on, I think it was Xbox Live Arcade, which was co-op Castlevania. Where you're all stuck in a great big massive castle. And it was pretty good. Sorry.
We're going
to get the thing on the left? Yep. I got the thing. And killed the man.
We're the best. We're getting all the things, we're killing all the guys. We're getting all the things.
Yeah. Now go up here, you get that chest.
I'm getting the chest.
Yes. Guess there's nothing up here.
Fine, I got it.
Okay.
Easy bonus level.
Yay! Easy peasy.
You
want
to get it?
I'm not. You said that the same way you say it to Pepper. Is that all I am to you?
No, you're also a cutie.
But you're saying that to Pepper as well. Yes, eat it.
I've heard you say that, Pepper.
I say take it when I give him dinner. Now his ears have perked up. You need to head off?
Yes, thank you for being lovely and supportive, chat. I apologize for being tense and irritable today. I promise to try and...
It's okay. We all gotta work for our livings. Also, this game tends to get you frustrated because of all the sequences that get lost.
Yeah, I don't know. I'm a perfectionist and I need to be more calm about the whole easy come, easy go sort of thing this game's got going on. But I don't know. I think part of the reason I get tense playing this game is because I used to like this game, and playing it with someone you love on a stream might not be a good forum for a game that you actually used to enjoy.
Fair enough.
There were several layers of that might have been a bad idea.
Well, I might turn the Wii off and see if I can set some nails up.
Alright, you guys have fun. I'm gonna go get my tires rotated, which sounds like a thing that wouldn't be a thing to me somehow.
Yeah, surely your tires rotate all the time.
Right! And also filled. The check tires light came on yesterday, but I already had to get them rotated, so I was just like, you know what? I'm gonna let them fill them up. I know that they fill them up when I get them rotated. I'm gonna let them take care of everything.
Here's a small picture of a dog while we wait for me to set up.
Come on, Pepper, we have to find my shoes.
Alright. Well, now that Kes is gone, it's time to be a man. For the man stream. For men. Bear with me, chat. I'm just setting up a game that we'll play for a bit. Not sure how long.
Honey, have you seen my backpack? Oh, it's right there.
There it is.
Perfect. Me and my purple patch are going. Doodle.
Have a good one. See you later.
Love you, sweetie.
Love you too. Alright, now everyone say what you really think. Oh, blimey, this game takes a while to start. Don't worry, the Steam list says it's running. How do we choose the name Pepper, Draco Ranger? Well, because he was black and white. Pepper, as in salt and. Alright, just a second. Yes, it's GTA 4, which I'm bringing out because I've been playing it a bit lately. Oh, I might as well just play a bit of my save. Yeah, Windows Live, remember that? Had to log in to play this bloody game. Let's turn the volumes down. Yeah, John Markley, if you would, change the game on the display. I should probably do that on YouTube, actually. Oh, but who cares? Yeah, I'm quite a ways into the game. Oh, there he is. Old Nico. Look at those kissable lips. As you can see, I've chosen a sort of Russian gangster ensemble for today. They don't make games like this anymore because they've learned from experience. Yeah, the trouble with GTA 4 is that GTA up to this point had always been quite a wacky game. Well, not so much in San Andreas, I suppose. But in this game, they really stepped up on the realism and the grittiness. So, let's do manly things. Let's assassinate someone, because that's what men do. Basically, the manliest thing you can do is bench press the engine from a classic American car while assassinating someone with the other hand. John Markley, just change it to Yahtzee's playing GTA 4, I guess, so who cares. Oh boy, keep my eye on the road and the eye on the chat is even harder than it was in Kirby. Hello, policeman! Boy, it's a good thing you don't get star ratings for traffic violations like you do in some games I could mention, isn't it? Like Mafia 1. Seriously, if you ran a red light, the police would, and a policeman was in sight, they'd come after you. It was slightly annoying. No, I really like Nico Bellic as a character. If only they didn't have the bloody friends calling you up to go bowling in this game. And if only they'd like maybe come up with a wholly different game that wasn't supposed to be facetious so that we could enjoy Nico Bellic as a serious character. Alright, who needs killing? That scene where like Nico's like confessing his sins to that religious mafia boss's wife. Classic writing, classic.
Hey brother, is there anything that needs to be handled?
I have a client with a problem. You'll get your normal.
No doubt, Light 9, I don't think driving control increases with time stroke skill in this version. I think that was a San Andreas thing. And the GTA 5 as well, possibly. Why GTA 4? I just felt like playing it. I wanted something to pass the time that had a lot of 100% completion bollocks in it, and this is what I picked. I like it. I like it the same way I like games like Elite Dangerous. Like long, boring stretches of not much happening and then little bursts of excitement that you appreciate all the more for all the stuff that comes in between. Count B. Monty asks, what would I think of a GTA set in London? Well, I guess you're talking about GTA London 1969, which was an expansion pack for the first GTA. Didn't really work that well, though, because they were still basing the map on American-style grid-based roads when London is a city that has grown up from 1,000 twisting dirt tracks over millennia. They didn't really capture that very well. Alright, off to kill someone! A 3D GTA in London, Silky Fennel. Well, what about The Getaway? That was set in London. Would that sate you? Does it have to be specifically called GTA? And there was an Assassin's Creed in London as well. Sandbox ain't just GTA's province anymore. Take your pick, really. Right, who needs killing? Oh, he's on a boat. Fun. A snipey mission, these are fun. Sort of makes you wonder why they gave me body armor for it, but never mind. Alright, everyone stay calm. I am a professional. Do not pay attention to what I am doing. Especially you, policeman. Gee, I wonder which one's the target. He should get that weird red thing floating over his head looked at. It makes him kind of vulnerable to things like this. Oh, hey, the rocking boat. Making this a bit more complicated. Wait a minute, isn't that Brian Blessed? I loved your work in Star Wars The Phantom Menace, Brian.
It's done, brother.
This is a regular account. I'll inform the accountant of your success.
You're welcome, Mr. Fixer. I suppose with a surname like that, there weren't many job options available to you. Blimey, I'm all the way across the map. Tell you what, and let me drive to the second island. And then maybe we'll call someone up to have a night on the town. Perhaps we could go and look at some... Oh, here's the other strip club. There's one obvious strip club that's part of a mission, but I never knew there was another one around. I can never remember where it is, so I'm just going to mark it. Oh, actually, I could probably go inside it, couldn't I? And that would mark it on the map. Yes, don't mind me. It's just very important I look at the inside of this strip club. Oh, yeah, they'll probably get narky if I have a fucking massive assault rifle out, won't they? Yes, now it's on the map. Now I can take friends to it. You know who likes strip clubs?
This is Brucey.
Alright, so I need to... I just specifically say, let's go to a strip club. Pick your baby from hundreds
online as you browse our baby creation facility. Rosie, man, how about we roll together and scope some beaches at the strip club?
What the fuck, FBI? I'm trying to get some rest from my intense cardio session, man. Call me up to 8 a.m., alright?
Brucey. Man, he's so desperate to hang out whenever I'm on my way to a mission, but the moment it's my idea, suddenly he gets all standoffish. Brucey's a card. We get on. Yeah, wise Frisbee. Remember when phones used to look like that? And this game's set in... When is this game set? Like 2007 or something. Thing is, I've befriended all the friends in this game up to the point where they give me the special friend bonus, like little Jacob sends you guns, and Dwayne sends people to back you up in firefights. I haven't quite gotten Brucey's bonus yet. Brucey's bonus. That's one for V-Ventar there. Is it past 8 a.m. yet? God, I'm so needy. Ah, fuck it, let's just kill someone. This is what you've driven me to, Brucey. You could have avoided this. Who left that car there? That was very irresponsible. Oh shit, police car! Good morning, officer. I am a sober Sunday driver. Phew, I think they bought it. Give me someone to kill. I got blue balls. I got Brucey blue balls. I got brew balls. Traveller 800, Niko Bellic isn't Russian, he's Serbian. Although apparently Niko Bellic is not a name that would ever appear in the Serbian language. If he was actually Serbian, it would be pronounced Belich. But, apparently Beli as a prefix is more of a Russian surname thing. Yeah, let's just kill some dudes, and then we'll call Brucey up, and then we'll go and look at some naked bitches. That's the plan. We're going to have a very manly morning. Assassinating people, and then looking at ladies' breasts. Alex RPC says you could look at the assassination targets and kill the strippers. I don't know. I've been cultivating Niko Bellic's reputation for efficient work. Is that one of the guys I need to kill? Because he's kind of obvious. Guess not. Right. Targets. This looks like it's another job that could be done snipey style. Ah, and there's a convenient stairway up there. Let's see how this works out. I'm just asking to be met halfway, game. No, can't jump over barbed wire. You'd almost think that sort of thing was dangerous. Come on, there must be a way in. There's a staircase to the top. There we go. You have to mash the A button to sprint. You just hold it down, he just sort of jogs. I think I saw someone up here, so I'd better prepare for battle. You. Oh yeah, there's someone. He's not armed though. That's okay. Thanks for not being armed. Okay. Don't mind me. Well, there's one. Right in the throat. And there's the others. You can't get me. Ha 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 ha. Stop moving. Stop moving. Damn, they're cleverer than I thought. Oh, don't make me come over there. Hey, you're not a target. Get out of my line of fire. Well, bugger. Alright, fine, I'm coming over there. Ugh. Why has nobody else got a decent work ethic? I was trying to do this efficiently. Bish bash bosh it would have been. But no. No one cares about my schedule. Everyone's just, I'd rather stay alive. Could we have a little meeting about it? I don't know why I bother. It's hard to assassinate in a woman's world. Hey, thanks for coming over. That was made things slightly easier. I'll take these so I can give them to someone more responsible. Right, where are you? That doesn't help, those are civvies. You're gonna make me run all the way down here. I just want to murder you all. Yeah, the lock-on in this game's kinda awful. But what do you want? They can't make it too easy for you. Okay, we're going across the way, I guess. Nothing will ever be simple, can it? Ooh, I've a good mind to file a complaint. Hey! Someone's got a long-range weapon here. It wasn't you. Don't shoot. I'm just a 30. Oh, there's the staircase. Nah, I don't shoot a man in the back. Alright, this is coming together nicely. Hey, we're on the flight path. Housing must be very cheap around here. And it's only getting cheaper. Gone to hell. Oh, there he is. Oh, don't milk it, love. Salt Vulture says, I miss days when you got like one sandbox in 2 years and you went nuts with it. Now everything's a fucking open world sandbox game. Preaching to the choir there, Mr. Vulture. It used to be special. Alright, he's on this level apparently. You'll note on the minimap, his dot is now plain red without an arrow on it. An arrow would indicate he was above or below me. There he is. He thought he could hide, isn't that cute? Alright, collected a bunch of old assault rifles, lost one nugget of armor health. I call that a good day's work. Okay. This ain't Saints Row, and I do not generate parachutes out of my arse. I will just have to get down. Does someone want an explanation for why I'm playing GTA 4? I don't know. Every now and again I replay old games that I get an idea in my head that I want to play. When I'm just passing the time and not playing games for work. And I thought to myself, hey, I feel like playing GTA 4. And I know it's a kind of a boring game. But sometimes that's what I want for a time-killing game. I just want to immerse myself in a world And as an immigrant myself, I relate to Niko Bellic quite a bit, although I haven't murdered quite as much as him. And again, we're in like the dead-end corner of nowhere on the map. Now, where's the fucking way out? Yeah, I remember we were planning a trip to the strip club. We'll do that. I just need to nick a fast car. Yours will do. This is a robbery. Get out of here. Hey, weren't you in Left 4 Dead 2? Alright, let's see, I called Brucey, but I have a horrible feeling he'll spawn in the middle island. It'll take me ages to get there. So I'm just going to drive a bit closer to it first. The Blue Riot bot would like us to know that he prefers San Andreas. San Andreas was a bit of a polarizing one. It was the first time the game started getting a bit less, you know, wacky. A bit less Saints Row level of wacky crime sandbox. It started to try to take itself a bit too seriously. And there was all that bloody business with the RPG elements where you had to work out doing repetitive mini-games to keep your muscle going. But it was a huge game, probably one of the biggest GTA games still, with three whole cities to explore. Also it had a jetpack, as Traveller 800 would like to remind us. Yeah, I quite liked Vice City, Silky Fennel. I think GTA 5 plays better than GTA 4, but GTA 4 I think has the better story and characters. I didn't like any of the protagonists in GTA 5. I thought they were all hateful assholes. And that notorious torture scene didn't help. Thing is, after Vice City, Rockstar sort of went, oh, we got a responsibility to do serious things about crime in Los Angeles or whatever. And then the Saints Row people said, we'll just keep doing wacky crime sandboxes and we'll take over that niche, thank you very much. And then they did very well with it. And now GTA's sort of a bit dowdy. Alright, let's call up our boyfriend. Go on, I want to try out this new strip club I found.
Hey, Brucey, want to hit the strip club?
A gentleman's club, yeah, sure, Henry. I'm excited, yeah! I'll wait at my place for an hour!
Sounds fun, man. I'll pick you up.
That's not your place, Brucey. What are you doing there? Ooh, fine, whatever. Yeah, Saints Row became sci-fi comedy. Ethan 265 Stapley. Everyone calls him NB, Alex RPC, for Niko Bellic. I guess he takes a certain pride from being named after a pencil. Handsome Aaron says, who makes plans by saying, I'll stay at my place for an hour? See, this is my point. If I could change one thing about this game, it'd be, when you call up your friends to go on dates and stuff, they come to you. They say, hey, could you meet me at this strip club, and then we could enjoy the strip club. So we don't have to fucking ferry them there and back. It would make things a lot easier. It'd be a lot more convenient to date your friends. Why is there so much traffic in this tunnel? It's almost like other people need to get to places. Don't merge inside the tunnel, you prick. It's a good thing I'm such a responsible driver. Okay. I'll stop going on about Hoony Pop Mathage 1. So Liberty City is based on New York. Is it obvious now? Red lights? I am not from your country. I do not understand the red lights. When I think of red light, I think of delicious borscht. And when I see the red borscht light, I go, That must mean, yes indeed, please continue and eat some of this lovely borscht. Silky Fennel says GTA 5 should have had San Francisco like San Andreas. Well, you could always play Watch Dogs 2. Brucey! My man! My baldy man. Alright, now for the very, very long drive back. Wise Frisbee asks how well the cars handled in this game. Kinda shittily. It was going for the realism thing.
Okay, now look, you're fast, and you're powerful, but unless you turn speed into velocity, unless you have
cinematic camera, not really helpful for telling where you're going, but it looks nice. Sorry, I was using the cinematic camera. What did I say in my original review for this game? The cars handle like there's a hippo sitting on the bonnet? Something like that. Yeah, V. Ventar once said he enjoyed the cars in GTA 4. But then he's into cars. Maybe he appreciated the challenge. I've played Watch Dogs 2 Silky Flannel, and it's not too accurate to the Bay Area because there's no Berkeley. There's just a big old field where Berkeley should be. I mean, not that it matters, it's not like there's anything important there, just the fucking University of California. Jesus! Ow, bugger, bugger, shit, ass. I think Brucey's one of the characters who appreciates idiot car stunts, though. Some characters don't like it when you go crazy in the car, some of them like it more. Don't mind me. Out of the way! Those tits won't ogle themselves! V. Ventar says, actually, Yahtzee, first day I owned this game on PC, the handling made me physically ill and I ended up vomiting. Man. Someone who likes cars, V. Ventar, you're a bit of a pussy. Not like me, I assassinate people and go to strip clubs. I'm one of those people who've never gotten motion sick from first person shooters. My mum did. She used to get motion sick if she was in the room while I was playing a first person shooter. I only started having to join the motion sick club when I was playing VR. Blue Pigeon says Yahtzee can make big boy jokes now that Kess is gone. Huh, it's funny because it's true. Alright, we're at the strip club that's called Honkers. Perhaps we'll steal a different car to go home.
Let's go see some women, man!
Brucey likes the strip club. In fact, I'm pretty sure every male friend you can take out likes the strip club.
Please, come on through.
Oh, it's in here. Well, where's the ladies? Oh, there's one.
Go. Come back there with me, honey?
Well, since you are so nicely.
Come with me.
What's up, homie?
Boy, it's a good thing they're all wearing things that cover their nipples and dirty holes. Otherwise, this might get us flagged. No, jiggle physics, Salt Vulture. I think that was after this game's time. Or they just didn't bother. Is it safe for Twitch? Good question. I mean, she's obviously got tape on the nips. I mean, what more do you want? Where lies the borderline? And it's not like they're actually having sex. Whoa, my controller's vibrating when she does that. Tactile. Well, not really. They haven't budged an inch. Alright, that's enough. Ah, Kess has seen it all before. Why aren't there any bar staff on duty? What if I want a drink? My friend would like a drink. Come on, Brucey. If they don't want our business, we will bid them good day. Yeah, they sure looked like they were, Brucey. Alright, pick a car. Ooh, convertible. I'll have that. Move 4, Ali says, hey Brucey, you want to go to the strip club for 3 minutes? Well, what are we supposed to do? I'm not staying there half an hour, I got people to murder. Oh, the cops are after us. How cute. And now the cops are not after us. That's how it works in GTA 4. You just have to get outside the circle for a while. ShadowFox89 says, Yahtzee, care to tell us the pissing on the tree story from your childhood? Well, it's not much of a story, ShadowFox89. I pissed on a tree. The next day, the headmaster of school said, someone wearing our uniform pissed on a tree in front of cars and traffic. And I felt very guilty. And nobody ever knew it was me. One time I even tried to confess. And my brother said, well, it can't have been you because we always walk home together. But he'd forgotten he'd ran ahead that day to be an asshole. If you're watching this, Mr. Alexander, I never respected you. I don't care that your school was let down by me pissing up a tree. Sometimes a guy's gotta piss up a tree. Sometimes a guy's gotta assassinate someone. And sometimes a guy gotta go to a strip club. And then maybe he'll do all of those things and then piss up a tree. You can't bring me down with your rules. Of course you're having me drive you all the way home, aren't you? On the far island. 1 mile, turn right. Okay, long straight. Let's see how fast this thing can go. Morning, officers.
Winners, man, and we got the hat.
Yeah, Brucey's into it. Brucey's the person you call if you want to do street races. He likes it when you go fast. Handbrake turn. Thanks, camera. You're a lot of help. Sorry, it's very important that I go down this way. I tend to spin out a lot when you try to do handbrake turns in this game. I usually use the handbrake turn more for doing 180 degree turns than the right angle turns. Not like Agents of Mayhem drifting. I've never played the Getaway Razor MDR 2012. I think I saw a Let's Play of it once. There was a lot of Cockney accents in it.
You have arrived.
There you go, Brucey.
Oh, with UMB. Let's hang out soon. We're winners, man. Fucking winners. Yeah.
Well. Maybe I can win a new bonnet for this car. Alright, hang on a sec. '67 Brucey like, 100% Brucey respect. Well, geez, Brucey, what do I need to do to make you like me? I'm very needy. See, Packy likes me. Dwayne likes me. I've taken Dwayne out a lot. Dwayne seems like he needs a friend. Tell you what. You know it, Brucey. Gotta make sure you're driving a fairly fast car when you start a, when you call Brucey for a race, because you're locked into whatever car you show up with. Only in this country would they let blind people drive.
Turn left. We're just keeping things positive all day, all night. Which ain't easy. This is right. This is right. Keep the vibe. Very much
in 100 yards. Funny, Brucey seems so insecure, yet he's been the most elusive friend to make so far. You thought he would have appreciated a bit of manly attention. Piss off, ice cream man. So, who's getting an urge to reinstall this game? Oh, there's the race. No worries, I'll just casually 3-point turn my way over to it.
You have arrived.
Yeah, you guys jealous of my hot ride? I bet you are. Wow, you guys are all shit at this. Yeah, I swear there's something wrong with the NPC driving AI in this game. At least since it came out. Everyone just doesn't know how to turn anymore. Most of the street races I've done, you mostly leave them behind during the first lap and then never see them again. Still, it's a nice day for it. Get out of my way, Mr. Classic Convertible. There's a new convertible in town. Yeah, I think we've pretty comfortably cemented our win here. Because one thing about these street races I don't like is that they're really stupidly long. Like, look in the bottom right, this is still lap one. We haven't finished one lap yet. Escapist1 says the story in 4 is a low point. I don't know, as I've said, I really like Niko Bellic as a character. But I take your point that the actual plot of the game is basically just running around doing errands for people the whole time. It's about learning about the past of this enigmatic and extremely private and withdrawn man. Haunted by the demons of his past. I guess somewhere along the line we started lap 2. Couldn't tell you where. Yeah, I don't know where those other bloody racers have gone. They're not behind me. I was afraid this car wouldn't hold together for the whole race. Probably wouldn't if this was, say, Vice City. Confessions of a Ladder Maker asks us, can you do anything in the sandbox with side quests and stuff, like start gang fights or something? Well, you can hunt down the 150 hidden pigeons. Shoot all the hidden pigeons and get no prize. Oops. Wrong road there. Oh, hang on, I saw some racers back there. Better maintain the lead, better take things seriously. And it's still lap 2. Oh, it's lap 3 now. Sorry, mate. Damn it, my car's smoking. It's probably been hanging with a bad crowd after school. Yeah, I guess it's not terribly interesting to watch, but it's okay. Because when it's just me on the stream, it's a chill stream. We're chilling out with some chill driving. We're Chill Clinton right here, who is the father of Chill C. Clinton and the husband of Chillery Clinton. Yep, it's this deceptive turn again. Phew! Pulled it off okay this time. Oh yay, photo finish! Okay, Brucey, now do you like me? Or do you only get respect from a person's missions? Oh, hey, we went up 1% in Brucey's estimation. Well, that's worth remembering. See, I'm hesitant to do a plot mission because you haven't been following the plot up to this point. This is like several million hours into the game. Let's just assassinate someone else. Can't go wrong with an assassination. Maybe just one more assassination and then we'll call it a stream. How about that? It's already ran on a bit. I got carried away with all this wonderful driving. Actually, classic convertible? Why not? I'll have it. I hope that constitutes the most spectacular way we could have discarded of the car. Oh, fine. Oh, what it is to be a streamer. There, that's probably disposed of it. Well, how'd I get 2 stars? What is it about what I just did that constitutes 2 stars, game? What the hell? Alright kids, this is what seatbelts are for. It's in case some asshole is for some reason parked horizontally across the road. Are you dead? You look like you're dead. Did I kill you? Hey, free car. Well, that turned out all right. Better notify Google Maps and let them know there's an accident on the highway. I don't need to take the money, Shadow Fox 89. I'm a very high-priced hitman. That's why I don't drive SUVs. Well, it's a good thing being hurled through the windscreen of my car didn't hurt me very much. Yeah, there's definitely been a downturn on the quality of the driver AI since the first time this game came out. Hello, Ursula's Twitch. How nice to see you. Oh, come on, guys. We're all trying to get somewhere. Hey, why aren't any of you in lanes? Lanes are a thing. Get out of my way. There are alive people who should not be alive. Oh, don't be such a baby, police force. Just grow up and deal with things like an adult. Yeah, see, he's decided to be the bigger man. Okay, I'm here. Now I can kill a thing.
I'd like some work, brother.
I have a client with a problem. You'll get your normal rate to assist them with it. The target you're after is on a boat.
Another one on a boat. What is it with this, with killing people on boats? What am I, Longshoreman X? You know what? I should put this rocket launcher away. It's cramping my style. Oh, thanks. A machine pistol. Just what I always wanted. Exactly, handsome Aaron. What if the boat moves somewhere else? You haven't been given much to go on. I just assume the extra details were texted to us on the quiet. Where are we going? Just up to the north of the island. Aha! I did not hit you that time! Gee, maybe I'm actually getting better at this driving lark. Red light. I don't answer to the man. Oh, hey, burger place. Well, I know where I'm getting lunch after I'm done killing people. Find a way to reach the target. Well, you're above sniper rifles now. Is that the target on that boat in the distance? Oh gee, I wonder how we could possibly get to the target. Actually, you know what, Nego, stand up first. Oh, this would be a hell of a shot if I made it. No, need more information. I asked my mother, what would I be? Will I be pretty? Will I be rich? Here's what she said to me. Kesara, Sara, whatever will be, will be. Oh, did I get too close? Wouldn't want to spook him. Oh, there's two of them. What do we think? Well, he is bobbing up and down a bit. We've only got two of these rockets. Oh, that'll do, pig. I was afraid the rocket was going under the water there. I'll contact your hard line. I'm a very efficient killer. That's why they call me the Ghost with rockets. Props to that guy. That was a slick dodge. Well, anyway, I think we'll call it a stream. Thanks for coming along this weekend for a bit of fun, a bit of Kirby, and a bit of actual fun. So, yes, this has been the weekend stream. I've been Yahtzee Croshaw. Kes was here earlier. Pepper's still here. I'll be back on Wednesday for the post-CP stream as usual. And Kirsten and I will be back next week for another weekend strip. Probably Dark Souls again. Follow me on Twitter at Yahtzee Croshaw. Subscribe to us on Twitch, twitch.tv/escapistmagazine. I can never remember all the things you're supposed to say at the end of these. John Markley and or V Ventar will probably be taking over later today. Possibly even as soon as I'm gone. They just can't wait to get rid of me sometimes. Alright, that's your lot. Ciao.